it was the sky. I was 10 years old. And in 1941, World War II started. New York was blacked out. And you could see the stars, and it was unbelievably beautiful and mysterious, and I wanted to know all about it.
Burton Richter, that boy from Far Rockaway, Queens, would unlock the mysteries of the smallest particles and contribute to our understanding of the theory of almost everything.
In the early part of the 60s, people kept discovering new particles. And the number of so-called elementary particles climbed and was approaching 100, and everybody came to the conclusion this couldn't be right.
These 100-plus particles were actually combinations of even smaller bits, known as quarks and leptons.
The thing that made me famous and Sam Ting famous is that in 1974, we discovered a particle that was not allowed to exist by the model we had at the time. There was something more.
Richter and Ting's discovery of the J-psi particle became known as the November Revolution. Awarded the Nobel Prize, their discovery advanced the theory of the standard model of particle physics.
I always thought about what the physics was and what I needed to do. I needed the colliding beam machine. So the Spear facility was very important. And I led the construction of the machine as well as the experiment. The legacy of Spear turned out to be much more than just this one particle. Because in the next year, another totally unexpected particle was found, which also earned a Nobel Prize.
Richter continued at SLAC, this time becoming its director in 1984.
What the real issue for a laboratory is not only what it's doing now, but what it's going to be doing 15 years from now. Science evolves, and what is going to keep your laboratory as one of the leading laboratories in the world?
Under his leadership, SLAC evolved into one of the leading labs of the world in X-ray science.
I have a trajectory from active researcher in high-energy physics to laboratory director to energy guru. In the climate and energy business, it is essential that the public understands that the thing that makes it hard is that it's not going to bother me. I'm 83. It's going to bother my granddaughters. And I think that the notion that we leave these kinds of problems to our grandchildren is just really a terrible idea, and it's unworthy of us.